In this video, we'll show you how to create a plan in GPS. When you finish creating your plan, you can seek approval from your course director. Start by doing a data refresh and selecting Process. This will update your GPS record in case you've made any enrollment changes today. This ensures you're working with the most up-to-date information. Otherwise, GPS updates overnight. Select Plans from the Plans tab and check you're on the correct course by checking the drop-down menu. If you already have plans, they will be listed here in the plans list. And you can see this plan is locked. This means the course director has reviewed and approved this plan for graduation. If you need to make any changes or edits to a locked plan, you need to discuss this with your course director. Let's create a new plan by clicking New Plan. You have a couple of options here. Blank plan, you can pick this option if you have just started your course or if you're partway through your course and you can pick what session to start from. Or select template. This option can be used if your course director has been asked to build an enrollment plan for you. Click select template and a number of plans will come up. Pick the session you want to start your plan from, so for us, session 1, 2021. And search for your course. You will need to know your course code, which you can find on your worksheets tab when you log in. And enter. You can see some 2018 and 2019 templates with different options here, such as full-time or online part-time. We can select a template from here and adjust it, but be aware it will need to be audited against your course structure and make sure to pick one that has the same starting session as you. You can see the name has come across here. Let's edit this plan. We'll rename it. So perhaps version 3, 4:41 PM, looking at enrollment options. Make it active so we know it's a current plan for us, and then we can have it reviewed and approved by the course director. Save. You can see it's updated here. Check the name and course. We can see it's active. The status is not locked, only the course director can do that. And we can see that the tracking status is not displayed. This only tracks when our plan is locked. As we use a template, we have a partially built plan. Let's scroll down and take a look. We can check the other sessions in our plan by clicking these arrows here. And we can change and edit this plan at any time whilst it's not locked. We could add a term if there were further sessions we wanted to add. Just be aware that future enrollment may not be available for you yet, as the subject availability is normally only a year in advance. We can see more information about the subjects by clicking on the menu next to the subject. We have more information. This tells us whether there are any prerequisites for this subject and when the subject is running, so it's a good way to double check the subject is available for the session that we've added it to in our plan. The enrollment plan does not check that for us. It will let us add it to a session, but won't check if it's actually available for that session. That's up to us and the course director. It also tells us the campus and mode available. We also have edit this requirement. This is where we can change the code, the mode, or the campus. And we have delete this requirement or reassign this requirement. We suggest reassign this requirement rather than deleting it, because then you can make sure you add it to a different session. We can move a subject to a different session. There's a couple of ways we can do this. We can go to menu and reassign this requirement. And we can change it to session 2. Click reassign, and you'll see BMS 191 is now in session 2. If we wanted to move it back, another way of moving a subject is by picking it up and dropping it into the session. It's now back in session 1. If you want to add a new subject to your plan, there's a couple of ways to do this. You can do so by clicking on the plus sign under the session. All of the subjects will list here. so we need to know the name of the subject or at least the discipline area. Let's add BMS 105. So under search by title, I'll add ScienceCom and enter. And you can see BMS 105 is listed here. We'll tick, it's added here, and add to plan. And you can see BMS 105 has now added here. We can click on the menu here and see more information about the subject. We can check the subject availability, so we can see that BMS 105 is available in Session 1 2021, and the campus and modes available here. This will help us when we're adding this subject in online admin. I'll delete this for now and show you another way to add BMS 105 to our enrolment. You can see we have the requirements menu on the left-hand side, and this menu is most likely what you'd use if you were building a plan from scratch. Here you can see we have choice, placeholder, or subject. Let's add a subject by clicking on the plus sign next to subject. Then you would add your subject information in here. You can see here that there's no term added. You would need to select that from the drop-down menu. Or another way is that we can pick up subject and drop it directly into session 1. And you can see the session is now pre-filled into the term section here. When we're in GPS, we must remember that when we type a subject, we need to leave a space between the letters and number. So BMS space 105. That's come up here. The points is populated and save. And you can see BMS 105 is now in our list here. The third way we can add a subject is to go back to this requirements menu. And if you click on the arrow here, we have the subjects menu. And you can do a search here. So let's add BMS 192 to session 2 this time. We can search by the title here, or we can scroll through here. BMS, and you can see all the BMS subjects have listed here. BMS 192, we can click on the information button here and this should show us when the subject is available and any prerequisites. Otherwise, drag the subject into the session here. And you can see BMS 192 has now added to our list. If we return back to our requirements menu, you can see the second option here is placeholder. You would use this requirement if you're going on a placement and want to add a comment or information. So I'll show you as an example. We can click on the plus sign or drop it into the session. So you select comment here and type your comment. And save. And you can see the comments now added here. I'm going to delete that for now as I don't want the placeholder in this plan. And if we return back to the requirements menu, you can see the last option is choice. Again, we can click on the plus sign here or drag and drop it into the session. You would use the choice requirement if you have options between subjects. So for example, you have two or three electives to choose from and you're not quite sure which one. Or if you had two core subjects that are offered in the same session, and which one you choose may be dependent on a prerequisite you still need to complete and you're not quite sure at this stage. So let's add a choice here between BMS 105 or CLS 202. So we'll type here BMS space 105. The subject comes up here, select and add. And then we'll type in here CLS space 202. The subject comes here, select. We must remember to fill in the points. So both of these are 8 points. And if you need to find out the points, you can check back on the more information menu. We're not going to worry about the campus or delivery, and save. You can see this requirement is added and the choice section is now listed here. If you do use the choice requirement for core subjects, you need to make sure you add it again so that you have both subjects in your plan to complete. And I'll just delete that now as I don't need it in this plan. You can also add notes throughout by clicking here next to session or clicking here if you wanted to add to a subject. You can see that notes have now been added due to the blue box around the note icon. These notes are only visible to you and your course director. You may see some subjects throughout have this critical icon. This means that this is a key subject. When adding subjects, you also have the still needed section. If there's any subjects listed here, you still need to add them. Otherwise, it looks like we've added all our course requirements in our plan. Now, as we think we've planned for all our subjects, we need to run an audit, which will open in a new window. Click here. Once scrolled down, this shows our course and the course structure. It shows that we need to complete 192 points and that we have accumulated 192 points. It shows our academic year as 2020. Our status is showing as in progress. If we scroll down, it shows our course structure. They show as planned, which means we haven't enrolled in it yet, or TA, which means we have enrolled. We need to be mindful that if any subjects add to this additional subject section, it's added here, which means GPS cannot find it, and we don't need it in our course structure. We may need to review our plan and enrolment with our course director. Once you are happy with your plan, you can email your course director to review it, and if approved, they can lock it for you. You must remember that building a plan in GPS is not adding subjects to your enrolment. This needs to be done in online admin, and you can do that using your plan once it has been locked. Check out our other GPS videos for help with adding subjects in online admin.